calling, oh sinner, come home. Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I cannot fall, listening every moment to the Spirit's call. Resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of Christ my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God.
Good morning. Welcome to the fifth Sunday in Lent. During these 40 days, we're celebrating the life and the sufferings of Christ for our sins. And through his sufferings, Christ has triumphed and shall reign forever. So let us rejoice as we sing 745, Jesus Shall Reign. 745. Let's stand together as we sing.
Thank you.
Let us remain standing as Ralph Sunheimer comes to lead us in our Old Testament and epistle reading from Jeremiah 31, Psalm 51, and Hebrews 5.
Good morning. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and Judah, not like the covenant that I made with their fathers, which they broke, even though I was a husband to them.
But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. I will put my law in their minds and write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
Have mercy upon me, O God, according to your loving kindness, according to the multitude of your tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions.
Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sins. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is always before me.
Against you, and you only, have I sinned and done this evil in your sight. Behold, I was born in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I will be whiter than snow.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me by your gracious spirit.
Even Christ, in the days of his flesh, offered up prayers and supplications to him who is able to save him from death, and he was heard because of his godly reverence.
Even though he was the Son, yet he also learned obedience by the things which he suffered.
Would you join me in the prayer of worship? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We come with humility and repentance before you, O God. Grant us your mercy and cleansing. Restore us to your presence, we pray. Help us through our sufferings to learn obedience just as Christ did when he walked upon the earth as the Son of Man. We ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us sing 568, Take My Life, 568.
Oh,
peace of God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us greet one another.
Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Lay aside the garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb.
It's good to see all of you here this morning. I'm glad that you dodged the bug that's going around, and I hope that you'll stay well. As for me, I'm planning to be so mean that no bug will ever want to bite me. I wonder if anybody has a blessing, maybe a birthday or an anniversary. Yes. All right. Ella's birthday. Anybody else? Any anniversaries? Okay, let's sing happy birthday to Ella. The announcements are there. Since Don and Arlene are part of our sick crowd today, we're not going to have choir practice tonight. So no choir practice tonight. Next Sunday is Palm Sunday. Reith and I will not be here. We're going to take some vacation, but Eric Walsh will be here. It should be a fantastic day, and hope that you'll be here. And Pastor Eric is always enjoyed by everyone. Hope that you'll be here for that Sunday. Next Sunday also, we will have confirmation class. Lacey will be coming in to show a video of church history of the United Church of Christ to our confirmation class, and then there'll be some discussion questions after that, and I'll try to find someone who will lead those discussion questions after that, and so we will have the confirmation class next Sunday. In the bulletin, you'll notice Lacey is going to be resigning as soon as a replacement can be trained. And so if you know someone who would like to have that position, please talk to me or to Megan. We want to say thanks to everyone who helped with the banquet last Tuesday. It was a great time. We had a lot of fun, and all went well until I started breaking dishes. We have scholarship applications on the foyer table. Graduation and scholarship day is May the 24th, and applications are due May the 3rd. Nothing complex about it. Just get an application, fill it out, turn it in to myself or Cedric Gerber, and we'll take care of it. Looking ahead, we have Good Friday service April the 3rd. Easter seems to be early this year, and it's kind of throwing everything off. But April the 3rd is at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Hope that you'll plan to be here for that service. We will have a communion that day, and we'll also have communion on Easter Sunday. I want to add one thing to our announcements that is not here. We'll have it in the bulletin starting next week. But the financial statements of the church have been changed, and we have two spreadsheets posted on the bulletin board in the basement. One is our income and expense for every fund, and also a balance sheet for every fund. If you have a fund that you are interested in, it would be good for you to kind of keep track of that downstairs. And if something is not right, make sure you speak to myself or Megan, and we'll make arrangements to get it corrected. I myself, just looking at it, saw a couple of things that probably need to be changed, but we're still working on that. And appreciate our finance committee for going through things and providing those statements for us. And I think you'll find them interesting. They're quite large. We have a lot of funds. So hopefully you'll be able to understand what you're reading when you read it downstairs. Any other announcements that you'd like to? Yes.
Real quickly, if you have not donated candy but would like to for Easter Sunday, feel free to give money to myself. We plan on, a group of us will be doing Easter eggs, stuffing them next Sunday. So if you'd like to donate but yet haven't, just let me know.
Okay. Yes.
Yes, the bar pack. We're going to pack on the 31st of March at 7 o'clock meeting. It'll be a Tuesday, because that Sunday is Palm Sunday.
On the 31st of March, 7 p.m., over at the First Church in, okay. Anybody that can help, be there on Tuesday evening, the 31st, 7 o'clock. Any other announcements? Let's look at our prayer list today. We have quite a few prayer requests, and we want to keep Wanda Berkey on the list as well. She has a torn retina. She's having to stay inside for several weeks, so let's keep praying for her. Are there any other needs that you would like to add to this list? Yes. Her name was Renee, and she was quite young, in her 30s.
She was 35. Yeah, her brother Tim was a classmate of, well, Karen, myself, and Matt.
She have children?
Yeah, she had three, like 7, 5, and 3, I think.
They certainly need our prayers, don't they? Anyone else? Yes.
Ben and I have been reluctant to stand up, but we had 2 snow days last month, and I haven't been down looking at the spreadsheet, and if I looked at it, I wouldn't know what I was looking at anyway, probably. But I have a feeling that we're behind on our giving, and I'd just like to remind everybody, like when Janie and I used to go on vacation, sometimes we were gone almost a month, and unfortunately, when we got home, we still had to pay for our direct TV. We had electric bill even though we hadn't been there all month. You know how it is. You still have to make the car payment even if you didn't drive it last month. You have a payment on your motorcycle, you still have to pay that whether you rode it during the winter or not. So I just remind everybody, keep up with your church and let's try and make sure we're on the right page with the finances. Thank you.
Man. I did not pay him to say that, by the way. I had nothing to do with it. Actually, everyone has been very faithful, and it's quite amazing to see that spreadsheet down there for all the bad weather we've had. So, well, let's join our hearts together in prayer, and let's turn to hymn number 10 and sing Glorify Your Name. Let's stand together as we sing hymn 10.
Thank you.
bow our heads in silent meditation. Oh God, we come to you with hearts filled with love, with hearts that want to glorify you. See our heart, Lord. Heal our spirit and help us to do your will. We pray for this world that we live in. Bless its leaders and, Lord, lead them to make the right decisions, to help those that are victims of tragedy. Oh God, teach us to do our part as well. We pray for our missionaries all over the world. Bless them, inflame their hearts, inspire their minds, protect their lives, and may Christ's victory be complete. We ask, O God, that you would help these on our list today. Some who are sick, many with other needs. We pray especially today for Wanda Berkey. We pray that you would help her. Heal her eye and touch her during these days when she's alone and by herself at home. We ask you to bless and give strength. We pray also, Lord, for the LeMay family, especially these children who've lost their mother. Lord, guard over them. You said that you are the father to the fatherless, the mother to the motherless. Help them, O God. We pray that you would as well give us the blessings that we need. As a church, help us to do what you want us to do as individuals and as families. Lead us and guide us to that level of stewardship and sacrifice and witness and suffering that you want us to attain to. We ask in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. You may be seated, and the kids can come up for the children's chat. Our resident children's chatter is gone today, so you have to make do. This could be dangerous, huh? Hey, did your mom and dad ever get after you for something? Okay, so then how did they punish you?
Sent me to my room.
Made you stay in your room? Did you suffer while you were in there? You didn't suffer? Oh, there's too many...